Alexander team, go closer.
Good morning. This is the team that is welcoming you. Uh-huh. The people who have been working hard to make sure that this happens. Uh-huh. And when we were told that you are the one coming, someone who loves God so much, oh. He said we are in business.
Amen.
And as we learn more, everything here is based on the Lord.
Yes.
We are doing it for His glory.
Absolutely.
You are going to open this. I am for someone to do that. Their sister. And that's why you are calling this particular place. So what is happening here is that we had been told that His Excellency will be here. So when you unveil and see the name, it could be you. Sir, you accept it.
No, he sent me.
Ah, that's why people are clapping. Yes, very, very much. So you are opening this as His Excellency. But as I have already said, we were excited because you are the one now going to do it. Because we know how you love the Lord. Is the sister coming? Oh, for this. So, the prophet, I don't know it very well. That's why I could ask Honorable Grace between to handle this. I don't know how to do it, madam. How do you do it?
No, I think
this is how the project.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen!
Hello.
Wonderful.
And this is us again.
Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you very much.
You can now remove the yellow.
No, let it just fly.
Officially commissioned by His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, who will be able to accompany the 20th July 2021. Thank you very much, Right Honorable Deputy Speaker. You're most welcome to cut the ribbon to officially access.
Amen.
The color is very similar to your dress.
Right, Honorable.
Yes.
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 Here
are
these houses.
Okay.
The fact that we are building a community, we knew that there was nothing that can happen without business around. We know that you promote wealth creation. So we expect people, they are going to form themselves into a housing cooperative.
Mm-hmm.
So if they want to go and buy in big quantities and stock here, so that they can buy at a good price, but also sell to the neighborhood. That's why we are starting from here. Secondly, we said, how do we get the names of the roads? We went to the Bible. Psalms 128 gave us the formula. The road that brought you is Gum Avenue. Blessings. The one that you are standing on is to do with faith. They are about to teach me how to spell it, but it is faith. The next one is hard work, and the last one is prosperity. All that in one single verse of the chapter 128 of Psalms. So these roads were designed in such a way that when children are grown here, they are riding bicycles, they are talking about positive rights. They will be the leaders of tomorrow, because they have lived in an environment where trees are planted everywhere, where the place looks like where we live in Corora everywhere. Every plot is serviced with the... There are people who might not raise all that. If you are living in another environment, no problem. This is a house we started with, four of them. This is a house where four are united, close to one another. You passed a fantastic law about condominium law. I think it is the best in the whole country. Why? That instead of having these small houses scattered everywhere, let them be brought together. So that you look at a big house. When someone says, I stay there, he's saying it with pride because the house is big. But meanwhile, it is a small unit of his. So that condominium law, if I was to praise the Parliament of Uganda, it is the best. It utilizes the space very well. But most important, it allows that you limit the cost because the walls are shared. And then most again, the fact that you are able to have a big house. Yes, what happened there, the breakage was as a result of a mistake. Yes.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and
the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
Yes, we could.
Starting the river to access.
Is it the main house site?
Yeah. But we have been allowed. A sitting room.
In a business way. The team that is here, Martha Achio, I would think she's our boss here, because without her, we wouldn't be here. She's the one responsible for the development here. Martha Achio, may God bless you. So is Isaac Okwir. They are the people who are based here. For us who are in Kampala, we only call, how is it going? And they do it very well. May God bless you too. Martha Mugarra is representing the Minister of Housing on the board. She is the Assistant Commissioner in charge of Urban Development. So when we formed this company, we said we must pick the best brains so that when we are going to develop homes, they will be the best. So I happen to be the chairman, Alex Kamkama, and by God's grace, I'm a Rotarian. Going to water sanitation, and the whole place will be beautiful. What we are calling upon all of us is to buy here so that we can get more money to go elsewhere. May God bless you.
It is okay. It's a great honor for me to welcome you to Lira City. This is Lira City East. And more especially when you come to commission this law to to the project team. We thank you for the great opportunity you've given us to see the housing project. I am very sure that our guest of honor has appreciated. However, the MP elect of the area, allow me to speak a little bit about the quality. Even if they are low-cost houses, please give us good quality. What we have seen today is good, but you can do better, so that the people of Lira can appreciate the good work that you're giving to us. I know there are going to be many more. Let them be fit for Lira City. And allow me now to invite my sister, Honorable Grace Kuichwin, to make her remarks, and then she's here with the Minister of State. Okay, and then she will invite our chief guest. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Ruth Acheng, Minister of Health in the country, MP-elect, my colleagues, members of parliament, Honorable Deputy Speaker, so much, because he could get time to come here even at short notice. I think we have to give him a bigger clap. Today is a big event for the Lango Cultural Institution. We are going to break ground in town where their plot is to construct their complex. And so when the director of this project came to me to say that they have a low-cost program to promote housing for low-income earners, I thought, why don't we put this together so that we can appreciate that Lira is a city and Lira needs a good housing scheme. And that is why we are starting with here, right, Honorable? Thank you so much. I want to appreciate, and ordinarily, I think the LC1 chairperson wouldn't have had the opportunity to ask the questions he has asked. Power, water, transport, good living. This is an eye-opener. And this is what we want for our cities. And I want to concur with the Minister of Health that what we are going to do here should be quality, which should be emulated and duplicated in all the cities we have in Northern Uganda now. Because the indicator of good livelihood is housing, one of it. If we want to know how well you are living, we can meet on the road, we can laugh, but the day we come to your home, people will ask, is this where he is living? Or they will be wowed by what your quality of life is. And for us in Northern Uganda, where poverty is real, housing is an indicator to show that we are getting out of poverty. And so this is a good project. The best message and the best we can do is let's do it well. So that once we build this, we build it like permanent, as it were. Because we are tired of temporary houses. We are tired of grass touch houses in the north. Even the grass has disappeared. Women do not have anywhere to cut grass from anymore. So, without wasting much time,
I want to thank all of you, the people who have financed it and the people who have bought into it. I want to thank you, because without conceiving the project, we would not be here. Without people joining you to implement the project, we'll not be here. And if individuals are not offered to buy and occupy them, we'll not be here. So we are here because three, four groups of people came together and agreed that this should go take place. And so it is taking place and we are here to commission it. Among the basic needs of a human being, housing is one important one. You solve the problem of housing, you have gone a mile to solving other human-related needs. So we're delighted that this should be taking place at this time when Lira has just become a city, at this time when we have the most powerful people coming into leadership of the city at this time. Gives great honor to them, but to give better honor to them, the quality of the things that should come up should be looking like them. I don't think we will tolerate work that does not meet the standard. I have looked at the building. I do a lot of building myself. Each time I see cracks in the building, I shudder. Like the Minister of Health said, low cost does not mean low quality. It can be low cost, but very high quality. Low cost means the materials used. Some of them are excluded. For example, you don't put tiles. Instead of tiles, you put red oxide on the floor. You have saved the cost on putting tiles. But does not mean the floor must be of low quality. The floor must not crack. It does not mean the workmanship should be some standard. I have seen the bathroom, for example. The person who did it should have cleaned it up properly without things sticking into the places. And, you know, even the plastering should have been done more smoother. Should have been smooth. Because that is not about low cost. It's about the labor force being used should make sure that the walls are real walls, as in walls of this kind of building. So I am happy, yet I would be happier. So do a little bit to make me reach my level of happiness, which I'd hope I would achieve today. But I want to thank you that this has happened. I came here on behalf of the president, who called me in the middle of about last night. He said he was not coming. And his message is, he does not like groundbreaking. Because the groundbreakings, many of them have let him down. I'm going to say it in the other place. He does groundbreaking, and then implementation of the project does not happen. It leaves his name in a bad place. He would rather come to commission something that is complete. And I'll be saying this in the other place. So, but this will have started with a bit of groundbreaking, with a bit of foundation. I mean, what is that thing called? The stone, unveiling the stone, with a bit of the buildings, but most of it is not yet done. So I am here on behalf of the president. So it must be finished. Because by virtue of me being here, it means he is here and is watching what is going to happen in his name. The plaque that is put there bears the name of President Museveni. So please, the conceivers of the project and the financiers of the project, let that not be a monument of humiliation in the name of the president. It must be a monument of success, because our president is a successful leader in this country and we should emulate him. So I wish you all the best, and may more people buy in so that the whole place is covered. And if I was to make a proposal, I would have just said Nye Link. Because ye irwot. Maybe it's better in Lao, but I would have preferred to say just nye ling. It would make a little more sense. Ye irwot. It's a bit long, and for Kamukama, he will never pronounce it all of his life, and yet is in charge of this project. So that would be my small suggestion. Nye is stronger and direct. It touches on the foundation of our faith. And if we are to believe in it, Niye would be better than Yeiru. So that would be my proposal for this. And may God bless you, and may this project succeed, and may the people who are going to live here, the children who are going to be raised here, live in the knowledge of God, because this premises, this area, the entire naming, the entire concept is based on the biblical principle. So may we have parents and children who love God and serve Him in His holy name, and be blessed, and may God bless you again. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello. Hello.
What do you think of me?
Hello.
After this, yeah. Wait, let the attack with the team on there.
On the other side, probably.
Yeah. I want to move up. I want to take that along. I want to move up. I want to hear. I'm going to take that along. I want Uganda. I want somebody. Oh yeah.
Shooting for Berlin and Meko Buginoro, Entaminiano, Copa one of Fumoyo, Laukan. Ikara may we be on Barroco, which I want to teach, but not only she was Karaja. Rapa Shimirodong, I made to teach my one to shoot. Now Chiuno Karachel, Chiuno Keremara. A Duong Karachel Kerewila Molovi, a Jolly Doshi Lao. My polo, me gum da beria kina white da kame. Why am I saying?
I am well aware that there's still an electoral process ahead, but I wish that these new members elect will be able to catch the speaker's eye. Much as where you are has been labeled the cultural center, The only pit standing is the pit behind there, which has been seen or known as a cultural center. And as a resident of this village, I have often had visitors who, after failing to find a cultural center, end up in my home, sometimes looking for anything connected to the Lango culture or the Lango history. I've had people coming to look for Lango cultural attire. I've had people looking for drums. I've had people coming to look for some historical documents or artifacts. But when they move up and down this road because they know that there's a cultural center, and failing to find it, they end up at my home. So I wish to appreciate the Office of the Prime Minister for bringing it to the reality, and I put the challenge now to the cultural institution to make it something which we can all be proud of. To have a name of the cultural center without having a cultural center is something which we need to strive to avoid. So on my own behalf, I welcome the Right Honourable Prime Minister, I mean the Right Honourable Speaker, to officiate on this important occasion. I'd also like to take this opportunity to congratulate all, including the Right Honourable Speaker, for successfully navigating through the elections. Of Lango Parliamentary Group, Mrs. Akena, I am inviting you as the chair of Lango Parliamentary Group.
Baburu Chingwa, Jode Wuru, Mark Betsy, Rababuru, Minister,
Minister for Kampala, MP for Oyam South, and MP elect for Oyam South.
Our chief guest, Deputy Speaker, Parliament of Uganda, apart Wondeo Mamara. In India, the only one to talk in the power. Langene Dood Mari. Koromwa Hadokien. No, me very bad of whom Waha Mia. Ya Yom. I would much have been you. I think on the WhatsApp name. A Papa case. Aku muduri yoto hadaha na beri chaden. Ateko ibasha za chim. Aku ane ile rie. Aku e piti cha tek mimi apaployo. Kuz nyo kes. Deko banye te kuane te puji la baloko kando mene pa nge tu pangamiru mede kum. Kando ti yera pa. Adrong Deputy Speaker. Gami pasu. Siware reo. Parmi les deux. L'anglais, il y a un cas de douce Roma pour faire. Pour vous, il y a un nom, il y a un pas, il y a un kirikini. Il y a un autre bête pour vous, mais il y a un autre jour. Il y a un autre jour. Il y a un autre député. Quand il y a un autre gireborro, il y a un autre député. So here I'm more prepared for me to be good.
Hello. Okay, you here today? Anya Paul Mara, a bit of MP elect, Mayor to my constituency. Get it done here to you, teacher Paul and Alpan. Aya, it's a big man business. Your investment are taking our part. What a journey, what a deal with your cook feet, and how many kind of work I have ever taken one, you have been with a man, a quiet technician. Right Honourable Speaker, Akapun Nyashi, Wakdishu Melaon, Nyeobido Dr. Samuel Opia Churi, MP elect Mekole No. Kedang MP elect to MP Nyen, Imwaha Nyen, Amerika Lojemia Nyen, Dan Timo Tene Lojema Nyen, Tati Melekan. Jokovonio Bin, Mer Inen, Onen Wani Wangi, Nen Wangwa, Anpa mito tania nen wangi nen wanga amito tan maho iri nene noni jami pime ne te cho bere be ane uni kole not constituency kodo kaname idon yere inyono gari yere abomondero abohe pano dushu anamito poye un lao dushu omede na otewani obame kodo medi ugun
Apoyo una tech, ana bedo Betty Engola, member Metala Menagamo, Mayor Bar District, and Papundeo, Personality Year. Awara Masha Jama Bar District, Ukero Domiko Kenikoma, Doko Duakania Meda Medeti. Apoyo una tech, Papundeo, Dejo Kamaru, Apoyo.
Right Honorable Speaker, Ame Tichungkawa President Yubani Apapun Nyasi Melango Your duty Wapapat American Anying Alwoni Okot Ogong MP Medoglu South
Apapun Deo Adwon Deputy Speaker May Parliament, May Republic of Uganda, I'm here in full over a team of Juan Cecilia Barbara. Opo, Unuba, a Papa meeting in a bear, we are a bit of senior citizen. Then I hear you mean the 11th Parliament, the Wanda Yeni. Representative of senior citizens of Erotie. Eno mio, ajo ata leka neko oro. No, ata mwriya bini kikye. Yen kyo adam don gor gor. Do gor vijo a chonge gor gor. Opo ba ameke li koso kan. Apa won deo, apo ame koko wakoso. Oba ame ugumba.
Right Honorable Speaker,
you have to protect us.
Can Honorable Santa Lumenti can Oyarion Ibarriol Joken Apekan Oswalo Kwena Mekisha. I'm a Chuck Dange, a poor Minister John. Ame Honorable Grace Kwi Uchinyu Leo Kakare. Honorable Rebecca Mugo Teo. Ame Nuchako Project Kike Dwa Gwan Members of Parliament na John. Don Project Ki Members of Parliament na Meonu Ti I Parliament na Mogi 2011. Ucha Here Kunasha Tebinu Dohe Parliament ne 2016. Ame Unumiero U Launching John. Enta Tamo. Kope moyo chenne pe yot. Miyo uwinge odangi. Chia moro. Project. Rangu binu. Chia mana chenne nukobo. Kane ti diya mapola me president commissioning. Ento. Wotpero. Ti utimere dushu. Manu beda chela me miyo uwinge odi. Jia mi cha herte uon. Mumon 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 rento. Chie. Manna tiye cheki. Ilaki da abushu beru muahamaya. Abira boru mere. Leto tindo cheki. I'm it up congratulating Honorable Grace Kwi Uchin, Metil Nwa Latin, I want to hear Meyakone. Honorable Grace, you have become a daughter here in Northern Uganda. Today you have delivered for us a baby. We want to congratulate you. Kono Grace Gangel Alu Rangel Ebna Mamon. Ah, Kiremen Jamame or Puru or Downing on your Kame to name packing team one, Binuti Merling one. So Jama Dick a war one year, yeah, and you know where we were, or better me one in the irony. Kadunga, I may you chin the med Jamino, Binutu go to Ted Erling on. Or me be the Sako, or me were the cooperative. Or may work in local government, or may work through cultural institution, yeah, work through your man, techwar, your man, mechanisha, your ekilija. Monogina do, and if you want to know, poor amo, love, yeah, me peda, love, get a joa, okay, bara, won yashiki, joken. Don't cooperate at tomb, jama me one moho, out at walking in the pier of your board.
Thank you very much for inviting me. Betty Akena, you are my daughter-in-law, but in Parliament, they identify us. I used to be Betty KCCA, and she used to be Betty Lands. Then we changed, I became Betty Lands, and she became Betty KCCA. So that's how we work very closely together. Thank you very much. I want to congratulate you for this great achievement, and I also to thank the President for fulfilling his pledge to the people of Lango for this wonderful initiative to have a cultural center for the people of Lango. Apoe Totoa.
Paul Machek, Adon Minister, Dini Loro Bondoa, Kulikoni Dino Kan, Pichinko, Pate Kapiratek, Dino Kalam Minister, Amela, Kobikum Logo, Kobikum Domogoma, Kobikum Woody.
Amen. Sami Oro Manyen. I'm so delighted today to stand before you for this function, which is long overdue. It has taken quite some time. It's almost like the long walk to freedom. And today we are here witnessing the groundbreaking. I want to thank the Right Honorable Deputy Speaker for coming in and standing in for the President on a very short notice to fulfill what the President had pledged before. I want to thank the institution, the cultural institution, for working with us all this time. I want to thank my office. I stood there and I was wondering what the PS is going to say. Like a mother would get worried when a child comes up and you wonder what is he going to say. But I have been given some strength to move on together with my team, because we have been there struggling all this time up to today. That in 18 months, that is our prayer, this project should be delivered. Today is a great day for Lango. We have had three activities this morning. This is the third one. In the morning, we had the pleasure to launch a construction at Lira Technical Institute, which will promote the institute to a center of excellence. It is a historical institute, and some innovation, something new, something creative has been added to it. That technical school is going to be focused on road construction. The skills that are going to come out of there is going to be, one major one is going to be road construction. And the students who are going to be trained there are going to be able to be employed at international level. So this is a big event for us. It's a program including administrative block, parking yards for equipment, worth 14 billion shillings. We went to the second site where a British company together with Uganda Cooperative Alliance has teamed together to promote low-cost housing in Lira. And this is in Gwenga Bara, It was a good function, and again I want to thank the Right Honourable Deputy Speaker of Parliament that he was able to witness. As we grow into cities, housing is very important for us. Housing is an indicator of good living. You are measured by what you live in. You are measured by where you come from. And if it can promote our low-cost earners to get good housing, we need to support that project in order to improve our lives. Now here we are launching the Lamu Cultural Complex, which includes an administrative block, it includes a cultural center, and it includes a palace. This is a 3.6 billion project. We have moved this far because we had so many challenges. We had technical challenges about it. We had traditional challenges, institutional challenges about it. We had financial challenges about it. Like I said, it was initiated a long time ago. And it would have been a big embarrassment for me not at least to start it. When Honorable Betty says, today I have delivered, for me I was feeling there that team for me, ayasha, ayasha, I haven't delivered. There are those three things, but it is good thing to yash, at least. Because I could be barren, but at least I am not. At least I have those three buildings. My prayer now is that these three buildings should be delivered in the 18 months. To show that that woman looks like pregnant and disappear, then you would, some people are named Okumu or Akumu. You don't know whether you're pregnant or not. I do not want that project to be like that. I want it to be a normal baby. That is why I have appreciated my staff, that they understand we are in it together. I have appreciated all of you stakeholders. This is our project. This is not Prime Minister's office project. This is our project which we have to support together. Monitor it, ask for quality, even ask for how much money is being spent. If there are any delays, ask. Because we can say it now, but there could be challenges along the way. And a new chapter, it can also be a tourism attraction. When we go to other countries, we visit palaces. And we even pay money for visiting those palaces. We would like this to be the same for us, so that we can earn money from this institution as well. I want to thank God he has brought us this far, and so we look forward in the few months to come that we can finish it. I would like to say a bit about what Honorable Betty for Northern Uganda. We are still poor, though Lamu region is better than most of the regions in Northern Uganda. We are still poor, poorer than the rest of the country. The government started with infrastructure under PRDP, schools, health centers, desks, and so on, teachers' quarters. But now the government is moving towards households, your own self, to be economically empowered. And for us, our best economic factor is land and agriculture. So we are looking at agriculture as the most empowering factor for us to transform our Northern Uganda. I am happy that for most or for all these meetings I have held with elders, with youth, with political leaders, we are speaking from the same page. We are all saying, yes, this is the time. We have to transform through agriculture. The other day at State House, I had Right great bishop Onwa saying, I have 100 acres of land, I'm going to plant maize. He said it before the president. Yesterday we were discussing maize. We are building from where we have had opportunities to grow. And so my appeal is that we can make it. We can transform our lives. We can do better than this. And already, Lamu, you are doing better than this. You are 47 factories, except they are not performing full capacity. That we can also do if we produce more. So I would like to appeal to you that in this next phase coming, in this next term of office of the president, please let's focus. We can do it. The government is ready to help with whatever it can help, and so we just need to buy in and move on. The mindset is also changing from dependency, when we came from war, to people asking, what is in it for us? What can I do for myself? For me, I think this is really great. With these many words, I want to thank you all very much. I want to pledge that we can still move together. And please, if there are any challenges, don't hesitate to let us know. Let us complete this project together. It is ours. It belongs to us.
Leaders, for the support you gave to the Office of Prime Minister during the process of procuring the contractor. The contractor is here present. The contractor, can I ask you to come forward so that the people see you and know that what we are doing today is for real. This project is supposed to be finalized in 18 months. While the Right Honorable Deputy Speaker was unveiling at the ground, the contractor said he will even do it in less than 18 months. We want to tell you that this word is taken seriously, and please ensure that you accomplish this project within the time set, but also produce a quality job. I want to use this opportunity to appeal to the district leadership and also the cultural leaders that together with us, we know we have a consulting firm that's going to be doing the supervisory, but we want to request you, this is a project that really means a lot for us. It's a project that means a lot for the cultural leadership of Lamu. Can you please, as the project goes on, can you do monitoring? Can you supervise? Can you let us know whenever there is something that requires to be pointed out, so that at the end of the day, we shall all be proud of the product that will have been produced. I want to end my communication without taking a long period. Here with us, we have the Honorable Minister, responsible for the delivery of this project, Honorable Grace Quinchwing. I'm sure at an appropriate time, yes, she's just right here. She's the one with the political mandate to ensure that this project is delivered. Honorable Minister, from the technical point of view, we the technical officers want to assure you that we shall ensure that the right job is done. We shall stretch it the most it can go to ensure that the right job is done in this place, and we shall all be proud of the product. Here with me are my colleagues from the Office of Prime Minister. Without going into details of introduction, they are here to ensure that what we are starting will get to be accomplished. Thank you so much once again for coming to grace this occasion, and we wish the best when everybody goes back to your places. Thank you so much.
Yes, to say something, but here I must also emphasize that we have only one Wanyasi who was elected, inaugurated, and confirmed, then gazetted. That reverse has never taken place. So we have only one Wanyasi, coupled with the fact that there was a court case yesterday but one, which confirmed the reign of Wanyasi of Lao. So when I heard the MC1 saying something that Rusu, there's no more Rusu, and there will not be any Rusu. You have seen clan members here and clan leaders, and all of them are crying. We are not invited all. If we had, then we would have had about 150 here. Some people claim they are Wanyasi, but they don't know where their roots are. So I want to make that very clear. And now I would like to welcome the ministers who are here. I also want to welcome the members of parliament. You're all here. I want to welcome the lordship, the bishops, and the other religious leaders. I want to welcome the resident district commissioners and the district commissioners, chairpersons, chief administrative officers, and city town clerk. In joining the Wanyasi, in welcoming you, are members of the cabinet, whom I've already introduced, and advisors, whom we have also introduced together, and we talk more now. I'm pleased to recognize the presence of my predecessor, Dr. Richard Nam, whom we invited to come. I don't know whether he's around. Is Dr. Richard Nam here? I replaced Dr. Richard Nam, and we thought he would be here. I hope, I don't know. I think he has not come. He's supposed to have come. I even talked to him, I invited him to come. Your Excellency, now in this case, our Deputy Speaker of Parliament, I read it as it is. Your Excellency, I wish not the satisfaction, the cordial relationship which has existed between Lao Cultural Foundation and the government of Uganda. We appreciate the support you've been giving to Lao in various sectors. The project you are launching today is one of the many projects the people of Lao requested you in Entebbe State House on the 19th and 20th. A team led by Wanyasi visited the president on the 10th and the 19th and 10th in the State House in 2009. And this is how the request was made, and that is why we are here today. We note with satisfaction some of the requests have been fulfilled, namely, we had also requested for Lira University erecting the monument and vocational learning institution in Balonyo and Abia Masaka sites. The Soroti Lira Road, the Kaguta Bridge, and the State House scholarships, supporting and granting more new districts to Lao. Now Lao has 9 districts, plus the city now will become 10. The ones in the process are compensation of rational cattle and construction of a Kibwa stadium. Your Excellency, today we are highly appreciative that you have fulfilled your pledge to support construction of Lao Cultural Center Complex, which is among the projects His Highness the Wanyasi Melao requested. This support is a landmark contribution to Lao Cultural Foundation and to the people of Lao as a whole, which will enable us to establish a permanent home which will consist of Palace of the Wanyasi, Office for Witong, Meeting Hall, Theatre, Hotel, and Cultural Village. So it's a complex indeed. However, Your Excellency, we would like to remind you on the other unfulfilled pledges made on that day, namely funding of Lamu Cultural Foundation to bring it to equal level with other kingdoms. Poverty elevation project to clan heads and clan members. They are supposed to have been given 2 IFAs for each clan head and building up the houses for the clan heads in appreciation of the role they restore in the promoting peace in Lao. Recognition and appreciation of the role of Amuka militia played in bringing peace. Appointment of Lao sons and daughters to positions of responsibility in government. Lao bought it very well. They definitely need a bit of that cake too. Your Excellency, we are pleased that government has provided bank facilitation to traders. But some of these traders who sold their things, who took property goods to Sudan, unfortunately, they have not been all paid. And it is therefore necessary that a way of paying them is expedited. Your Excellency, Lamu Cultural Foundation has some serious financial challenges which have adversely affected its performance. It has no operational funds to enable employ technical staff and meet office expenses. No transport facilitation, office equipment, furniture and materials. In earlier engagement with you, Your Excellency promised to provide 60 million for office operations. We request that this payment be expedited. As I conclude, Your Excellency, I wish to inform you that Lamu Cultural Foundation has developed a 5-year development plan. And this strategic plan is for 2021-2026. We believe Lamu Cultural Foundation has been beggars. We've been depending on donor support. Can we find a way to make our own money and move the institution better? Now, the defined strategic objectives here are one, enhance the institutional capacity. Two, conserve and promote Lamu Cultural Resource. I want to say something here. And I will only say this one, but the others, I will leave them like that. We know that all Lamu came through Utuhu, Utuhe. Now, our thinking is that we build a gateway at Utuhe, which will be a cultural tourist center. We also know...
Then speech and
No, 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 no,
Mm-hmm. Patire chetana ko dona duong kai ni wo. Rua, melao. Odi tuba. Rua, kini ko ko rua ko ko tu chuno ni no ko ko ante. No, es que no hay nada corto. Y en la arena tiene luz. En el que ya uno ni más. Que el lado, nada de. Como porque el enemigo, a mano que vive que ganó. Vive con la alma. Y tengo que hacer ya otro, que no ya ha tocado. Yo ya tengo una guaya, yo estoy en el mundo. No voy a llorar que culo. Como mano me olvidaba, dice. La última de la buena, uru. Como la última, 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 como la Bota duro, ele compra melhor o povo. Então, comigo o mamãozinho. Negueiro, na atal com um. E eu já tinha como a gongo do ano. Eu cabo com o gongo, já lhe digo, o troco da paz. Amando o pinitinho no ano, o dia que era na pique. Quiere la biblioteca, hermano. No quiere ni venir. ¿Ya? Uy, yo me quise. Uy, yo me quise. Uy, yo me quise. Era pique. Era pique. Era pique. Yo me quise. Era pique. Yo me quise. Yo me quise. Ya fuera de un que me coja. ¿Quién es? ¿Qué quiero? ¿Qué da? ¿Qué se da? ¿Qué se da? ¿Qué se da? ¿Qué se Por menos con el que ya hay. Yo guardo un dinero. Tú voy a. Guardo un gorro y ahora no me lo quiero. Y el día de tu. El gorro me la pongo. El gorro me la pongo. Mande. ¡Gorila! Por tu gorro y me la pongo. A mí me cuento, me queda igual. Y esta última vez que el Juan, yo al loyo guapo de viejo. Todo viene de Juan. Yo, o corrido, o perma. Ay, duele, 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 duele.
¡Pero no le voy a decir a ti, cheque! ¡Arra, a ti, o cabo! ¡Tal cual que yo al cheque que va a tomar! ¡Cala tu ero! ¡Cala tu chuco! ¡Y me iguale! ¡Aguala!
To invite our chief guest, the Right Honourable Deputy Speaker of Parliament, who is representing the President, to come and give his speech.
Thank you. Thank you.